buat luanya ciar kekan ki bera boma yi cielo mo en rang ne jo mi mama ni gu no yo kwa An ke ma ke ma para che ni ma tiar ba ngwen adu ni ma li ba rio ka ngwen Ini nak apa parcel?
It was 3 years, one day. I remember exactly because I was counting from the age of the 13. Then
Gulu is a district found in the northern part of Uganda. It's about 350 kilometers from the capital city of South Sudan, Juba. And also about 326 kilometers from the capital city of Uganda, Kampala. And the Lord's Resistance Army was started between 1987 when Joseph Kony, the leader of the Lord's Resistance Army, emerged and started a rebel activity. From 1988 up to 2006, so much atrocities were committed by the Lord's Resistance Army. Over 30,000 children were abducted. Some of them returned, some of them died. So many young girls were captured by the rebels and turned into sex slaves.
Grab and ke ma ke ma para che ma tiar ba ngwen adu ke ma ka le ba rio ka ngwen edu ma te no a ke kan pan cha pa no pra dai le la te pra pan cha bi ra che ka ne ke ma ka ke mi na te ma te ma wo de wo de wo de che ngwen be du ma te
Kata pihak ni dek, macam ni lah kan. Cina dah nunggut dah man. Hanya lah ke Lucy, nanti kita akan parang way. Anu way jom aku mak awan ni, kita mak aku gang wap. Idi wo cabi sih ni di wo.
Some of our people whom we were abducted with went to Southern Sudan, others went to DRC Congo. I was abducted when the rebels came to our village and we were running with my sister. She was shot by the rebel and the rebel came and then slaughtered her with a panga when I was seeing. So I was very traumatized. Joseph Kony was the LRA commander. He was the one leading all this.
2006, the situation changed when the peace talks started in Juba, South Sudan, between the government of Uganda and the Lord's Resistance Army. And they move away from northern Uganda into South Sudan, and they move into the Democratic Republic of Congo. And as they talk right now, the LRA are actually in Central African Republic. So there is no more fighting here.
Right now, as I speak, there is no war in northern Uganda. That is when we we experienced the brutal killing and then the trauma and stigma, it never went away until to date. I was gang raped by the LRA commanders. Not only one person raped me. I cannot count how many people. And it was difficult for me even to walk. I feel the back pain. I was forced to marry someone, a very old man. Which it was really very difficult for me. At that age, I was young.
Yeah, my name is Agnes. I'm Kimara. I'm a teacher. I'm going to talk to you. 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 I'm going to talk to you.
Eno tila lungko kon. Mona Rio, mati bot eng. Jom kena keliling wa kabung wen, jom kena wa apa biar dek wa yang wen bare. Kum dah pi dek ang wen nao ni.
They give you a big man to be your husband, even you could not refuse. If you refuse, even they will cut your hair, also your mouth. Also the leg, also the hand.
Mado per kaboro, wachi ni mera siara bot pengkangera loan bana. Siara kwa era wan pabu loan bana. Cuma macam ni mana kita pati kami atau anak kau ni kena rio, anak kau ni kuat kita. Vorme kira lain kita anu ni. Macam dulu anu ni cakap mahu vorme anu mahu anu anak kira.
I wanted this girl, then they were looking for the tiny girl. He told the man, commanded the man not to use me. And I was forced. He used me. Yes. He had about that time 52 wives. When I escaped, he had about almost 63 wives now. To fulfill the needs of the men so that they don't leave the military. They know men will look for women. They might leave being supporting him.
Because they think if they do it like that, you will be pregnant. They left you with the child. That is another word for you. So you can be suffer like that.
Because the women will give birth and multiply and add the number of his militaries. And they will be trained as militaries, the children who are born.
So they have children, they are responsible for the children. It's like you are in a family. So they always go back into the bush. They fight, they go back because they have their families.
called Moses. I was born in 2000. My mother is a victim of LA. She was abducted when she was 14 years old. She got my father from there, who was a rebel. My father forced my mom to sexual violence. Yeah.
After her father died, there was a serious killing which happened around our home, around the village, around the camp where they were staying by the rebels. Now, the neighbors started suspecting that she was the one who brought that thing. But after that murder, I was neglected among the other friends. My friends were kids even. So I was rejected. I was never allowed to play with other neighbors' kids. So I felt very bad. Okay, according to me, they started calling me Coin. Because by then I never knew who was the leader of that thing. So they can call you Kony to mean that you are one of the people, yeah. Said, hey, so this is who I am. This is who I am. This is what I passed through. So I felt it was very bad.
Some of them, the relatives, don't want the children born from captivity. Their parents are a rebel, so they call also them names. Sometimes they don't like them. Even people who are abducted during war, not all of them are being wanted in the community. They don't like some of them.
So they feel they can take away their properties again, as they had been doing in the rebels. And those children, again, which are born out of captivity, they fear them because they think they have the blood. They may come back home and kill them. So they don't want to mix with them properly.
This thing is still happening because even I did not see my father. I didn't see my father. And I just found myself in this situation now. So it is very... it's very painful. It's very painful because I don't have a dad even. Because knowing that my father was among the rebel and he was doing such thing, like sexual abuses. So all those things he did, some kind make me feel that I am the one who did it. I just feel that I am guilty. But there's nothing I can do now.
Gin ma mir wacha ne ira yeni. Yoni po beru bad ma mi po beru tim ma ira ye timo. But in ben gin weli kian gin kore yoni. Ento latien pe penyo ka kwen ka mir gin wale ni ye. Aka mo ye kian latien ma.
From the bush, some people stigmatize me that I'm a bush lady. Really, my family, they did not support me. They say that I can bring for them problems. If I reach home, even I can carry the gun to shoot their children, even though I'm the children of theirs.
The committee was seeing them that they are the one who are killing people. So a lot of stigma, a lot of discrimination. So and yet you've been abducted and you are the one who didn't kill and you have been made forced.
When you get a woman who has been in the bush and man has been using, it has a shame on you. And when they realize, they can chase them away. You feel it's a shame to you, it's a disgrace, it lowers your dignity.
I got HIV AIDS. The second man is the one who gave me HIV AIDS. When I came back, the life was difficult for me. How to get treatment was difficult for me. All these things, it gave me traumatized. Life is not easy. How to survive is difficult.
Did the government do anything to support?
They do not give me the support.
Government money.
So I decided to look at this, how can our people best be supported? How can the children born out of war be supported? So we come up, we normally share, have stories, we talk about it, and then we bring new ideas. I need to begin, as a survivor, I feel the pain. I need to support them, be with them directly. That is why Golden Women Vision is.
1, 2, 3, begin.
Ma wax odoto tawane diirena ramu berbe tamma ki nyuaro e golden women kirma ka wagu war wan pi wa ken wa waloro mi na tek twin wera furnena a beru kunu a neno en ma chalo gi moma ti chalo alaga loga kuona
la ti ngana kombe chane chana mara ti ni ti ga konya ganga ara tigi lu tena ngwen ngo kan ni an kana ki mucha na mara gamwe ni met ki cham met pa ore perom
most of the survivors are dying. They will die before getting the reparations. Something need to be done, but we shall continue as an activist to push. Kim Bok-dong and received this beautiful, wonderful, great peace prize, the grandmother. Which will remain in me to be strong and fight for justice and work as an activist throughout my life.
The problem Kim Bok-dong went through, I know it very well, the same as me. We can survive from the survival time we passed through. We can be happy to stay now.
this is the beginning. From here up to that side, we are going with you to see the mark. From here, we shall go straight. Can we? All up to there is our land.
전쟁으로 무참하게 인권이 짓밟혔던 한 여성의 삶이 죽는다고 해서 죽는 것이 아니라는 것. 수많은 아이들에게, 수많은 여성들에게 희망이 되고 평화가 되어서 그 여성들이 자기 자신들의 삶을 개척하면서 살 수 있게 만드는 나비로 그렇게 세상에 뿌려진다라는 것. 나비의 날개짓이 세계를 향해서 확산된다라는 것을 의미하는 것이기도 하고요.
important the world should know, because we're also part of the world, because the same suffering may be happening in some other world, and like the killing, like insurgency. So the insurgency that was in northern Uganda, other people in China or in America, they doesn't know. So this is the time they should know.
Each of us, we know the problem of any passion among us, the way each person suffer. This thing can be solved if there is no fighting, no war.